kitchen, and I'm sitting for Sheikh Muhammad Salah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him full shifa, cure, and recovery. Ameen. Before we start, I would like to welcome the mashayikh, as usual, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq and Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Barakallahu feekum. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of the Quran. They are the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam made it very clear. And one of the ways to do that is to recite the Quran and to reflect upon it and to act according to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to get to it, inshallah ta'ala, we'll listen to the recitation from Surah As-Saffat. This is where you guys stopped. Surah As-Saffat, verse number 123. Verse number 123. And Sheikh Abdul Khaliq, please go ahead, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم وإن إلياس لمن المرسلين إذ قال لقومه ألا تتقون أتدعون وتدعون أحسن الخالقين أتدعون بعلا وتدعون أحسن الخالقين الله ربكم الله ربكم ورب آبائكم الأولين فكذبوه فإنهم لمحضرون إلا عباد الله المخلصين وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على الياسين إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين وإن لوطا لمن المرسلين إذ نجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا الآخرين وإن إنكم لتمرون عليهم مصبحين وبالليل أفلا تعقلون
وإن يونس لمن المرسلين أبق إلى الفلك المشحون فساهم فكان من المدحضين فالتقمه الحوت وهو مليم فلولا لَلَبِثَ فِي بَطْنِهِ إلى يوم يبعثون فنبذناه بالعراء وهو سقيم وأنبتنا عليه شجرة وأرسلناه إلى 100,000 أو يزيدون فآمنوا فمتعناهم إلى حين.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. As we heard this beautiful recitation, and these verses that we need to all reflect upon and act upon the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As you heard before in the previous verses, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to the disbelievers at all times, at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, at all times, reminding them and reminding us of the prophets of Allah, the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on earth that never changes. And as you see from one story to the other, and then after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would refute the ways of the disbelievers, proving to them that the purpose of their life is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And these messengers of Allah, they came with one message, calling their people to worship Allah, to be obedient to Allah. And once that happens, people, they split into two groups, the believers versus the disbelievers. The believers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honor them, as it's mentioned in the verses, from one story to the other. And they will be admitted to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hereafter. And their mention from one generation to the other is praiseworthy one. And as for the disbelievers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them after the message have been established, after the hujjah, the clear evidence has been established against them. And when they refuse arrogantly, they refuse the truth, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, after warning, then they are to be punished from one nation to the other, different ways, but at the end, they would all receive the same abode and the same destination. So as we heard in these verses, after the mention of Prophet Musa alayhi salam and Harun and so on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned Prophet Ilyas. And some said that Prophet Ilyas is Prophet Idris. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, he stated this. So Prophet Ilyas is from Lamin al-Mursaleen, from the messengers of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him. Who's the one that sent him? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth. So indeed, he is from the Mursaleen. He was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What did he say to his people? إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ أَلَا تَتَّقُونَ When he said to his people, shouldn't you have taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Shouldn't you have the fear of Allah? Shouldn't you be obedient to Allah? And as you see that the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how it's mentioned in the Quran and how the messengers of Allah presented this, presented to the people that they already know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the Lord and He's the provider, the sustainer. So why not then be obedient to Him? Why not worship Him alone? Why do you associate partners with Allah? And then after that He says to them, أَتَدْعُونَ بَعْلًا وَتَذَرُونَ أَحْسَنَ الْخَالِقِينَ You are invoking Ba'lan. Ba'lan is the name of the idol that they used to worship. That's the name of it. So you're invoking that particular idol and you're turning away from the best of the creators, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah, your Lord, and the Lord of your forefathers. He's the Lord of all. And they would acknowledge this, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that also about the people of Quraysh. But it wasn't sufficient for them to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Lord of the Alameen. Even the people of Quraysh, they believed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was the Lord of the Alameen. وَلَئِنْ سَأَلْتَهُمْ مَنْ خَلَقَ السَّمَوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ لَيَقُولُنَّ اللَّهِ قُلْ أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ So if you say to them, who created the heavens and the earth, they would say Allah. But then the same thing or the same ending of the verses mentioned here, then shouldn't you then be among the people of taqwa, those who have fear of Allah and dutiful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is the most clear evidence that no human being with reason whatsoever would be able to oppose the power of the tawheed and the evidence to establish the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And it shows how foolish the human beings can reach when they worship idols and images other than Allah. And it really doesn't matter whether people, they worship an idol that they made from stone, carved from stones, whether they worship angels, whether they worship a prophet of Allah, as it will come in the surah. You know, this is the lie that people, the human beings, they invent about Allah. No messenger of Allah whatsoever called the people to worship anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Even though what the people worship, they might worship a messenger of Allah, honored by Allah, but the fact that they are doing this shirk and associating partners with Allah is as evil as worshipping anything else, whether stones or trees, or it's the same category of kufr and disbelief and shirk. So when they denied Prophet Ilyas, what happened to them? فَكَذَّبُوهُ فَإِنَّهُمْ لَمُحْضَرُونَ. They're not going to flee away. They will be brought. They will be brought to the judgment day. They will be brought by the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're not going to be escaped. They won't be able to escape from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You see, the verses, since it's brief and it's meant to be this way in this context in the surah, it doesn't mention the details. Of course, the messengers of Allah, they didn't just say the message in one sentence and then the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came. They were patient to the people. They called them and they invited them with all kinds of leniency and goodness. And these messengers of Allah, not just normal people, they are the best of their people. The best of the people that are known with their trustworthiness, with their truthfulness, with their piety. They are people that never lie whatsoever. So whenever the matter is explained to the people more than one time and then they deny it and there's no more means of their guidance, then the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to them and nobody will be able to escape from the punishment of Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they all will be brought to the justice of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the punishment of Allah, illa ibadallahi mukhlaseen, except the slaves of Allah, al-mukhlaseen, the pure ones, the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purified them for His worship, the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose and purified to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, those who accepted the message of the messengers. And that's for the nations before, this for this nation, this is for nowadays at all times. Are we among those who accepted the message of the messengers of Allah and the final messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or among those who, al-'ayadhu billah, those who rejected the message or denied the message? So these are the two categories of the human beings, fariqun fil jannah wa fariqun fil sa'ir, a group in jannah and a group in the hellfire. So who are the group in the jannah? Those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purified, they worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And al-mukhlaseen versus those who commit shirk and associate partners with Allah. Mukhlaseen in their ibadah to Allah. See, ibadallahi al-mukhlaseen. They are the slaves of Allah. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala purely. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the ways of the messengers of Allah. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. And not just that the message was only to the people, those who were at his time. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continued for the praise of Ilyas alayhi salam for the later generations. Now we read about him and we see alayhi salam and we mention his name many times. And this is something Allah knows best how long ago this message was. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed from one messenger to the other, praising the prophets of Allah. And how what really matters is what stays at the end. How many times even people, imma of this deen, ulama of this deen, they might have faced all kinds of difficulties in their life and they were not known to the people and they were not very famous and they struggled and faced all kinds of trials, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala kept their name after them and their praise after them and for people to benefit from their knowledge after they passed away. Because the true believers, they don't really care about the fame in this life. They don't care about how people know them or they don't know them or whether they praise them or not. They are mukhlaseen, they are purely worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, seeking the rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And it's by the mercy of Allah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep their mention in a good way among the believers till the day of judgment from one generation to the other. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised the Prophet alayhi salam, salamun ala ilyasin. And this is one of the dialect of mentioning a name with a noon at the end. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised him. And peace upon him, peace be upon him till the day of judgment, and he's among the chosen ones in the day of judgment. And this is the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the ayah which is repeated in the surah, إِنَّا كَذَلِكَ نَجِزِ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. This is how indeed we reward, recompense. Who? The muhsineen, the good doers. So those who are good doers, they do the good deeds with goodness, with the fact that they, as if they are seeing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if they don't, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is seeing them. Those who purified their actions, and all of these words, they are related to one another with regards to al-ikhlas, with al-ihsan. All of these words can be synonyms to one another, and one means more things or more meaning than the other. And the believers, they have these characteristics in them. When they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone with this level of al-ihsan and goodness. And if they do that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward them as we heard. They will be chosen in this life and in the hereafter, and they will have peace and security and so on. And why is that? إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُؤْمِنِينَ Indeed, he is from our believing slaves. The best honor that a person can receive in this world is to be among the believing slaves of Allah. Everybody is a slave of Allah, everybody is in state of submission to Allah, but the special slaves of Allah are those who are believers and those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala honored them for them to worship and to humble themselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the essence of the ibadah, as we heard, when a messenger is sent to the people and they denied him, right, versus those who believe in him and accept his message, this is what the ibadah is. To humble oneself. What's the thing that makes the disbelievers deny the truth? It's the arrogance. And arrogance negates the essence of ibadah. There's no way that al-ibadah, or to be a slave of Allah, or to be in the servitude of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with a seed of arrogance in the heart. That negates it. Unless a person remove that seed of arrogance, as he removed that arrogance, that means he humble himself, submit himself to the creator of the heavens and the earth. Then after that, as we heard, the mention of Lut alayhi salam. وَإِنَّ لُوتَ لَّمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ Lot. Lut alayhi salam, indeed also he is from the Mursaleen. And the matter is repeated, and it's meant to be that way in the same context that we hear like this, because there's a benefit here. There's a meaning that is being stressed to give comfort to the Prophet ﷺ and to warn the disbelievers that the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the same. So Lut alayhi salam, he was sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whoever denied the messenger, he had denied the one that sent him. And this is something that human beings, they function this way in this world. If a king or so, he sent a messenger from him, whatever the messenger, ambassador or a messenger, whatever he speaks, whatever he conveys, it's not necessarily that individual that is acting on behalf of the king. It's as if the king himself is saying these words. So therefore, if someone rejects his words, as if they rejected the words of the king, and wars sometimes are raged as a result of this. So the same thing, and to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the best example. The messengers of Allah, they have been sent by Allah through the wahy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Lut alayhi salam was among the messengers of Allah. And in this particular surah, of course, the mention of Lut alayhi salam throughout the Quran in some places is more in more details than others, but to serve the objective of the surah, whatever is mentioned is needed when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِذْ نَجَّيْنَاهُ وَأَهْلَهُ أَجْمَعِينَ When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِذْ And remember, as if you're witnessing that, if you see that, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him and his family and his people, أجمعين, all of them, إِلَّا عَجُوزًا فِي الْغَابِرِينَ Except the woman that reached age, olden age, which is the wife of Lut alayhi salam, she was among those who are destroyed. And that also shows the justice of Allah. That it doesn't mean that a person is close to a messenger of Allah, that they will be saved just for the fact that they have lineage or they have relationships with them. It's all about one's actions and one's belief and one's submission and so on. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved the believers with Lut alayhi salam, ثُمَّ دَمَّرْنَا الْآخَرِينَ And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed whoever is left. And they were destroyed and ruined because of their disbelief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, associating partners with Allah and committing this act of sodomy, which is one of the most disturbing, that is against one's nature and pure nature that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human beings with. And it's mentioned in other parts of the Quran with regards to the crimes that they committed. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding the people of Quraysh about the fate of the people of Lut. He says, وَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَمُرُّونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مُصْبِحِينَ وَبِاللَّيْلِ أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ That indeed that you pass by them in the morning and during the night. You know their places. You know the places of the people of Lut whenever they would travel to Ash-Sham and so on. They would see. And they know that these are the places of the people of Lut when they were destroyed. So you saw what happened to them. So therefore, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ Shouldn't you then have reason? Shouldn't you use your reason, your intellect, which is the very specific thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to the human beings, that makes a human being unique, different than the rest of the creation of Allah, and that's why they are responsible for their actions, because they can use their reason. They have a mean of reasoning things. When they see the destruction of someone, then they should return back to themselves and take a lesson from it. If a person is walking in the street, and he sees someone that crosses the street without looking, if there are cars coming, and he gets hit, and then immediately after that, that person would do the same thing, he is someone that is a fool, basically. Someone that did not use reason. Human beings, they learn from previous experiences, at least. And this is something even laws get legislated as a result of things that happened in the past. So you would find governments and rulers and people of authority would set rules, whether it's justified sometimes or not justified, but based on previous experience of nations or people and so on. So this is one of the things that human beings, all of them can relate to it. So when they see the destruction of the nations before, then أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ Use your reason, and how to use their reason, in which they would protect themselves from the evil consequences of their actions, so that they don't fall into the same end as the people of Lut, and as these nations that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed. And it shows how the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encouraging the people to use what Allah gave us. Allah gave us al-aql, the reason to think, to make decisions now for what's coming ahead. أَفَلَا تَتَّقُونَ Shouldn't you have the fear of Allah and the obedience of Allah, that since He's the creator of the heavens and the earth, then He's the one that ought to be obeyed, and He's the one that ought to be worshipped, and so on. And then after the mention of Prophet Lut alayhi salam, again we can go on to details of what the stories of these prophets of Allah. But because the ayah or the surah mentioned them in certain way, with brief in this context, it's meant to be this way. And that's why afterwards the story of Yunus alayhi salam, but we won't be able to cover what's mentioned in the verses because of the time. But before we get to the break inshallah ta'ala, and before we receive your phone calls and correcting the recitation, leaving you with this meaning, that the messengers of Allah, they came with the same thing as the words are repeated, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose them because they were pure, and they turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And the punishment of Allah on these nations for the disbelievers to take a lesson and to take heed before it's too late. And the same thing for all of us. So we'll go to break inshallah ta'ala and come back with your phone calls and the recitation to be corrected. So stay with us inshallah ta'ala.
Write it every day and do read it loud.
We have Sister Maryam from the UK. Go ahead inshallah ta'ala and recite. وَإِنَّ إِلْيَاسَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ
السلام عليكم
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. Go ahead inshallah.
How are you, Shaykh?
الحمد لله ما شاء الله. How old are you?
I am 8 years old.
ما شاء الله 8 years old ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you and bless your parents ما شاء الله. Mashallah, go ahead and recite, inshallah.
Okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wa inna Ilyasa laminal mursaleen. إذ قال لقومه ألا تتقون أتدعون بعلا وتذرون أحسن الخالقين الله ربكم ورب آبائكم الأولين فكذبوه فإنهم لمحضرون إلا عباد الله المخلصين وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على الياسين إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين وإن لوطا لمن المرسلين إذ نجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا الآخرين وإنكم لتمرون عليهم مصبحين وبالليل أفلا تعقلون وإن يونس لمن المرسلين إذ أبق إلى الفلك المشحون فساهم فكان من المدحضين فالتقمه الحوت وهو مليم فلولا أنه كان من المسبحين للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون فنبذناه بالعراء وهو سقيم وأنبتنا عليه شجرة من يقطين وأرسلناه إلى 100,000 أو يزيدون
وأرسلناه إلى 100,000 أو يزيدون وأرسلناه إلى 100,000 أو يزيدون قاعد شاء
وأرسلناه إلى 100,000 أو يزيدون فآمنوا فمتعناهم إلى حين صدق الله العظيم
بارك الله فيك أمين الله سبحانه وتعالى as I said bless you and bless your parents and bless your teacher ما شاء الله and may Allah protect you إن شاء الله تعالى and keep you steadfast and make you the people of the Quran and memorize the entire Quran and to act according to the Quran إن شاء الله تعالى بارك الله فيك إن شاء الله طيب with the verses that we stopped at the beginning of Prophet Yunus عليه السلام وإن يونس لمن المرسلين that indeed Yunus from the Mursaleen, from the messengers of Allah. Yunus as usually translated the name Jonah. And Prophet Yunus alayhi salam is one of the great messengers of Allah and his story is an interesting one. And also the surah mentioned some of the things that is needed. And one of the amazing things in the stories of the Quran that many details might not be mentioned, but lots of these details you can already know it when you recite the verses. When you recite the verse, and the verse, for example, the next one, إِذْ أَبَقَ إِلَى الْفُلْكِ الْمَشْحُونَ when he was taken to the laden ship, the ship that is full of people and so on. What happened before that? Right? Maybe this is not that significant to know here in this context, right? Because what matters here is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the surah. But there's some things happened before. And that's why, for example, you would see that what happened when he فَسَاهَمَ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْمُدَحَضِينَ فَسَاهَمَ they drew lots, and he was among those who lost the lot. So something happened in there. But you know that from other parts of the Qur'an, when they had to get rid of someone, to cast someone from the ship, so they got together to draw lots of who to, you know, they would lose or they would sacrifice for the sake of saving the rest of the people on the ship when they were facing a huge storm. So all of these details might not be mentioned, but you're already understanding this from the words فَسَاهَمَ فَكَانَ مِنَ الْمُدْحَضِينَ So he lost in this. So what happened? He was cast into the river or into the sea. It did not say that he was thrown into the sea. It said in the next verse, فَالْتَقَمَهُ الْحُوتُ وَهُوَ مُلِيمٌ. That means he was taken by the hutu, by the whale. So the point here is that this is what happened to him, and he stayed in him, inside of the hut, inside of the whale. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned here that what saved Yunus alayhi salam. Before we continue with that, we have Brother Idris from Nigeria. Go ahead, inshallah ta'ala, and recite for us, inshallah.
What surah?
Yes. Go ahead, inshallah. Wa inna ijasa. Wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
What surah?
Surah As-Saffat and verse number 123.
Anyone?
Surah As-Saffat and verse number 123. وَإِنَّ إِلْيَاسَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ.
Mursala?
As-Saffat.
Assalamualaikum.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
As-Saffat.
نعم. Or if you want to recite anything, go ahead. If you want to recite any verses, it's fine, inshallah. Just recite for us, inshallah. Because of the time of the program, just recite from any place, inshallah.
All right.
Whatever you want to recite, any place, go ahead, inshallah.
Yes.
Go ahead. Okay, we lost the call. Just call us back, inshallah. Barakallahu feek. So again, when we see the story of Yunus alayhi salam, what saved him, really, and this is something that for us to reflect upon, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلَوْلَا أَنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الْمُسَبِّحِينَ. That the fact that he was from among the musabbihin, those who were making dhikr of Allah, remembrance of Allah, glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and because of that, that since he was among the people, those who make tasbih and dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if it wasn't that, he would have stayed in the whales, inside of it, till the day of resurrection. And because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him. Allah saved him because of his amal, salih, righteous deeds, the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And al-musabbihin refers to the dhikr in general, to make remembrance of Allah. And tasbih specifically is mentioned there because with the tasbih, people are provided for. And this is something that came in some of the text and the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that with the tasbih, with subhanallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provides people, provide those who are living, and that's why the birds, the animals, everything make tasbih to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they are being provided for when they are in that state of remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and glorifying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it shows the virtue of the tasbih, the virtue of the righteous good deeds, and a person would then appreciate it so much in the time of need, takes the person and save him whenever he faces types of trouble, as it happened to Prophet Yunus alayhi salam. But then after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him, it's not mentioned in this context why did he go to the ship and why he was thrown and so on, because that he left his people and he was angry with them because they did not believe, but he left without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what happened to Yunus alayhi salam as a test for him, because he left his people without that permission. And after he left them, they believed. And this is what is mentioned in the verses. But after Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved him, and he was in the ara, in the openness, and he was sick as a result of what being inside of the hut and so on, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with his mercy, he protected Prophet Yunus alayhi salam when he grew up a tree of growed vine next to him to give him shade and to protect him and so on. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him to 100,000 people or a little bit more or more, whether it's the same people or other people than the ones that he used to be with them before, as the ulama they mentioned in the tafsir. And they believed, and this is something strange, because as the previous stories, most of the people, they disbelieve in their messengers of Allah, and only the few among them, those who are the believers. But in the case of Yunus alayhi salam, his people believed. His people believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and worshipped Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them time of ease and goodness as a result of their faith and as a result of them submitting themselves to the truth and to the message of their Prophet. And then after that, after the mention of these stories, you would see then what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying to the people of Quraysh, to the disbelievers in general, to learn from what is mentioned before. And this is by the mercy of Allah for people to use their reason and their intellect. And what happened to the nations before, believers versus the disbelievers, for people to take lesson not to believe in Allah, to look at themselves and how they degrade themselves when they associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as you also saw from the very beginning, from the mention of Ilyas alayhi salam, and before that in the surah, that how the word al-mursaleen and al-muhsineen and al-mukhlaseen, the messengers of Allah, the truthful ones, and so on. And all of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them. We have Abu Maryam from Egypt. Abu Maryam from Egypt. Go ahead, inshaAllah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Go ahead and recite for us, inshaAllah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. وَإِنَّ إِلْيَاسَ لَمِنَ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِذْ قَالَ لِقَوْمِهِ أَتَتَّقُونَ أَتَدْعُونَ بَعْلًا وَتَذَرُونَ أَحْسَنَ الْخَالِقِينَ اللَّهَ رَبَّكُمْ وَرَبَّ آبَائِكُمُ الْأَوَّلِينَ فكذبوه فإنهم لمحضرون إلا عباد الله المخلصين وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على إلياس إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين وإن لوطا لمن المرسلين إذ نجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا الآخرين وإنكم لتمرون عليهم مصبحين وبالليل أفلا تعقلون وإن يونس لمن المرسلين إذ أبقى إلى إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين وإن لوطا لمن المرسلين إذ نجيناه وأهله أجمعين إلا عجوزا في الغابرين ثم دمرنا الآخرين وإنكم لتمرون عليهم مصبحين وبالليل أفلا تعقلون وإن يونس لمن المرسلين إذ أبقى إلى الفلك المشحون فساهم فكان من المدحضين فالتقمه الحوت وهو مليم فلولا أنه كان من المسبحين للبث في بطنه إلى يوم يبعثون فنبذناه بالعراء وهو سقيم وأنبتنا عليه شجرة من يقطين وأرسلناه إلى 100,000 أو يزيدون فآمنوا فمتعناهم إلى حين.
ما شاء الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. Very nice recitation, ما شاء الله. Nothing to correct, subhanAllah, mashaAllah, very nice. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for all of those who are learning the words of Allah. And I would like to remind myself and others, the time that you spend to learn the Qur'an, to recite and to act according to the Qur'an and the tafsir and so on, this is the most precious and the most blessed time. And it's a way to save this religion, to save the deen of Al-Islam with the ilm, with the knowledge, that you take this religion to the next generation as it was at the time of the Prophet ﷺ. The Qur'an, the place of the Qur'an is in the hearts of the people, not necessarily in the physical thing that the Musahif and so on, but in the hearts of the people. So to recite it, to memorize it, to act according to the book of Allah. And it's a book that the more that we recite, the more that we repeat these verses, the more that we would get affected by it. And as we heard in these messengers of Allah and these prophets of Allah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praised them. How did He praise them? Did He praise them because of their names or because of their tribes or because of the characteristics that are mentioned there? So characteristics are mentioned there. And the disbelievers, characteristics, it's not, we don't even, hear the name of the disbelievers in these verses, but we get to know their characteristics. So those who came later in these generations, today, at all times, those who would fit the description, they would receive the same fate, whether it's good or evil, according to one's actions, according to one's patience or the opposite, following the desires or following the wahi, the revelation from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept from all of us and to make these types of gatherings a blessed one. And if we have been deprived from many of these physical gatherings in many of the masajid nowadays all over the world, we should not deprive ourselves from these special gatherings and majalis of the recitation of the Qur'an and correcting our recitation and learning from the book of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward the mashayikh, Sheikh Abdul Khaliq and Sheikh Abdul Rahman. Barakallahu feekum. And till next time, inshallah ta'ala, inshallah we'll be with Shaykh Muhammad Salah, inshallah, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him full cure. We'll see you then, and sallallahu wa sallam, baraka al Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation, and we were chosen to be part of his nation.